Good day and welcome back. Today we're going to look at the magnetic field and to investigate its effect on the moving charge. At the end of this video, we should be able to explain how this the magnetic field is produced, and we're going to learn about the formula of the force on the moving charge, and then we're going to define magnetic flux density, and we're also going to describe the motion of the charge particle in the magnetic field. First, we're going to look at the concept of a magnetic field. So you have learned a lot of magnetic field before, that the most common source of the magnetic field is produced by the permanent magnet. Second thing that you have learned in STPM physics, that when you have current carrying conductor, so there's a magnetic field produced around the conductor. So you have learned something called the right hand grip rule to identify the direction of the magnetic field produced by the current. So in simple, magnetic field is a field of force produced by permanent magnet or a current carrying conductor. Or we also have learned that current is actually the rate of flow of charge. So magnetic field also can be produced by moving charge. So next we're going to look at how can the magnetic field act on a moving charge. So you have learned about the Fleming left hand rule. So the thumbs representing the motion or the force. The first finger is representing the magnetic field, and the second finger is representing the velocity of the charge. So you are given with the formula of F equal to QVB. So notice that the force, velocity, and the magnetic flux density are vector quantities. So the direction of the force can be obtained by the cross product of the velocity and the magnetic flux density. From what we have learned before, so if there is the angle between the V and the B, so the magnetic of the force can be expressed as QVB sine theta, where the theta is the angle between the velocity and the magnetic flux density. So from this formula, we can define the magnetic flux density, that the B is equal to the ratio of force to the product of Q, B, and sine theta. Based on the formula, so magnetic flux density can be defined as the force per unit charge on the charge particle moving with 1 meter per second at right angle to the magnetic field. So do remember that the unit for magnetic flux density is Tesla. Next, we're going to describe the motion of the charge particle in the magnetic field. First, let us understand what is the force acted on the charge based on the situations provided in the learning outcome. So for the first case, that when the charge is moving in direction parallel to the magnetic field, so the angle between the V and B is zero. So when you substitute the 0 degree into the formula, so you could get that the magnitude of the force is zero. So this means that there's no magnetic force acted on the charge when it is moving in parallel to the magnetic field. So compared to the second case, when the charge moving in the direction perpendicular to the magnetic field, so the angle between the V and B is 90 degrees. So you have learned in max that sine 90 degrees is the maximum point in sine graph. So the magnitude of the force when the angle is 90 degrees is said to be the maximum, that is equal to QVB. So graphically, when you have a positive charge in the magnetic field as shown in the diagram, so you can either use the cross product of the V and B, or you can use the Fleming left hand rule to identify the direction of the force on the positive charge. From the method, you should obtain that the force is acted to the left. So when you look at the diagram, that you can see that the force is always 90 degrees to the V. So this is something that you have learned before, that it is the centripetal force, and it will cause the charge to move in a circular path. So we have the formula of the force is QVB, that it is also a centripetal force acted on the charge. And the formula that you have learned before is the force equal to mv squared over r. So we can equate both these equations, that we can obtain the radius of circular path as the mv divided by qb. So let's say we have the velocity of the proton is 1 multiplied 10 to the power 5 meters per second, and the magnetic flux density is given as 1 tesla. So from the value given, we can calculate the radius of the circular path. You put in all the value and you could get that the radius is 1.04 millimeter. So after we learn about the effect of magnetic field on the positive charge, now we're going to talk about another charge, which is the negative charge or the electron. So comparing both proton and electron, we know that both of them are the opposite charge with the same magnitude. Recall back what we have learned in the electric field. So both will show an opposite reaction. So based on the formula of the force equal to QBB, where the force is depending on the charge. So when you're dealing with a negative charge, so you can apply the same method that either you use the cross product or the Fleming left-hand rule, except that the direction of the force will be reversed since the force is negative. So if you have the force acted to the left, so it will be reversed to the right, and the electron now would be moved in clockwise direction in this case. Regarding the magnitude of the force, it is still constant since the magnitude of the charge of proton and electron are the same. Another thing that we can compare about proton and electron is their mass. So we know that the proton is heavier than the electron. Previously, we have derived the radius of the circular path that is equal to the mv divided by qb. So the radius of the circular path is linearly proportional to the mass of the charge. So the proton will move in a bigger circular path than the electron. So that's conclude my discussion for today. If you have any questions regarding magnetic field, you can leave it in the comment section. Also, do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.